But, Francis, listen, I can say this to you candidly right now, that I regarded you as a bloody nuisance for this reason, that you would pop up at the most inopportune times. You get what I mean?
Yeah.
And you didn't seem to realize it.
I've never ever lost the feeling.
No, you seem to take me as your godfather.
That I could come in here at any time, night or day, and ask you for some assistance.
All right, I'm just going to say, you regarded me as your godfather for information about the sewerage, and there it was. I was bound to give it to you, whether I bloody well liked it or not. You've got to learn one bloody lesson. You're the worst listener that ever I've had anything to do with. You've got so much in your head, you want to come forward with it before you even get the answer that you've asked for the first time.
This is a story about a homecoming, about an uncle, and about a sewerage scheme. The homecoming is mine, back to Australia after some years away, back to the beaches, back to relatives too, to see what they've been doing. Francis Sutton was always a surprising uncle, Joan a most practical aunt, Jonathan about my age, Gina, I remember, loved dressing up. Angela, the piano. David, the youngest, the skinny kid. And that's me on the left on one of those great Christmas holidays long ago.
Do you want to see some of them?
Yeah.
How long since you've sort of seen these? 20
oh,
years?
Maybe I have never seen
them. Perhaps you've never. Mm. But I don't see them often. Occasionally they arouse interest in...
Joan is my mother's sister.
Guess the first thing that turns up.
Let me see.
A beautiful boy in the garden with daisies.
Wow, 17.
Michael, were you 17?
Yeah, I think so.
Oh, yes, and here's one of your mother doing, it was called Eurythmics, I don't know what they call it now. Yeah, right in the centre.
Where's that?
I think that's in the Botanical Gardens. This was a group and I don't remember really. She was terribly energetic. Oh, she would have been about 18 or something.
If you fly over the area of Sydney, you can very easily pick out these areas. They are an intense dark brown sludge. Going up and you will see it floating.
Okay, it's a waste product. Most waste products can be used. What's it made of? Liquids and solids. Liquid. Treat it and you have water. Water. How much is there? Can you afford to throw it away?
Sydney will run out of fresh water in 25 years. In other words, all of the treatment plants that the Sydney Water Board are building now are obsolete now.
It really is amazing how maritime peoples, cuddling up to the sea, loving it really, can so perversely pollute it. Dr. Mullins and Francis, like growing numbers of people around the world, seek to stop this stupidity.
Francis, couldn't I make the bed?
Just got to, I must finish it. I must finish it before I have breakfast, really.
The last couple of weeks, he doesn't always hear when spoken to, and that's a sign. And last night, he said it was raining heavily outside. It was quite late and quite dark, and he said he could hear birds singing. Well, this could have been just an accidental thing, or I'm not, you know, I was a bit worried, really, because I know he's terribly short of sleep. And he's been working on this for so long, you know, 2 years, I suppose, even on these plans, so it's not good, really, and he's not young.
He's devised a scheme to pipe sewerage inland. It looks good on paper and was well received at first. But now rumours about its cost are killing it before it has a chance to prove itself.
Is that the new pipeline you're going to suggest?
He's a layman without any engineering training. So unless he can get experts to verify his hunches, the Sutton scheme will probably go no further.
What I really came for was to see if you want a cup of tea.
Yes, thanks.
Do you want anything to eat?
No, thanks.
Right. He's got some unusual quality there that is capable of putting everything else aside. As you know, he does nothing, you know, about the house. He doesn't attend to any of the...
Do you think you become obsessed by sewerage during this sort of...
Well, it's not sewerage, it's the environment. I'm obsessed with the environment, not sewerage.
It's hard to live with a man obsessed. Jonathan doesn't. He's a plant pathologist now, 500 miles away in Melbourne.
Time is 7 o'clock.
Angela has virtually disappeared. Gina is sometimes home. David is totally involved in his studies and his surfing. And Joan, too, has her escapes.
I'm now going to classes on Aboriginals. And it's in the university in the evenings, you know, once a week. And as you know, I write occasional verse.
Do you? I don't know.
You do. I gave you a lovely one about Nixon. I wrote you liked it. Don't you remember?
No, I
don't remember. Oh, Michael. Then you were being insincere. You said you thought it was good.
Sometimes Francis ventures out to speak in public. This Thursday, I follow him to a high school on the Central Coast, 60 miles north of Sydney. His scheme would serve this growing area.
I suppose I'd... listen to me talk, I'd better tell you a little bit about myself. I'm a commercial artist. I've been a commercial artist most of my life. And I spent a lot of my time in advertising.
Well, as far as he's concerned, he spent most of his life, all his working life, doing a sort of soul-destroying advertising, you see, which is one of the very worst jobs anyone can do. And now that he's found something that's worth doing, well, he's idealistic and he's enthusiastic and optimistic. And... tenacious.
When I was your age, I always came for my holidays up in this area. It was a very wonderful area and still is. And I became very fond of it. And I got a little weekender up at Baddow Bay.
Francis, don't forget the milk.
Yes, I was here as a kid. I used to come across the lake in either one of these boats to the entrance. And we'd unload all our suitcases, the whole family, the little kids, we'd all be carrying suitcases. We'd take them out and we'd put them onto these drays, horse and cart. And I didn't know until I met Mac that he used to be the bloke that got took the suitcases from us and put them up on the top of the dray.
Up to Bayview. Now tell me this, France. What year would you come here first from memory?
Well, it would have been about 1923 or 24.
I see. Well,
like
I was interested to know when you said as a kid. It makes me older than I thought I was. Well, I came here in 1916. I'm 77 this year. So you're very much younger than I thought.
Gosh, that's only 10 minutes, 10...
You've still got a...
Well, how old are you now?
I'll be 77 this October.
77? Well, I'm 61.
Oh, yeah.
16, 17, maybe. I don't remember.
Do you feel old when you look at that?
Feel old. No, don't feel any different. You don't feel any different when you...
Baddow Bay. I remember having holidays there as a kid. Wonderful holidays. And now I find myself in some of Francis's slides. But for Francis, the bay is spoilt. For at one end of the beach, there is a cut across the rocks. The cut covers the sewage outfall pipe, which releases effluent at the rock's edge.
And down here, hear it pouring through from the whole of the entrance area. All the
All the sewage effluent from entrance and the surrounding districts all going out there. A disgraceful destruction of a beautiful area.
The Batter Bay Works is secondary treatment of the trickling filter type, a safe effluent when diluted.
Well, it's a... this is known as the entrance sewage works.
It's called trickling filter because the effluent at one stage trickles down over stones on which live millions of tiny bacteria waiting to gobble up impurities.
The sewage works at Batow Bay itself is only within about 2 or 3 years old. What will happen to those sewage works and the rest of the sewage works on the Central Coast? Because if by your scheme, I don't know, but if they are closed down, it will be such an extremity, you know, such an extreme waste of money, it would be unbelievable.
We've simply spent a lot of money purifying water out of our paying our rates to purify this water, and then we're throwing it away. But the economic argument surely is that now we should purify it a bit more and use it.
For Francis, the effluent is not itself disgusting. It's a good resource in the wrong place. A fertile mix, needlessly degrading his beach.
Look, can you see the brown in it there? You can see it quite clearly. That's human excreta. And it comes across, it comes right across the rock shelf here and it goes right into the swimming areas. Smells terribly sometimes. Whenever I ran into problems, I went to experts to find out what the answer was. That's the way I've proceeded to develop a scheme which will not only finally recover our little Batow Bay down here, but also all of the other areas.
We go aloft over high school and treatment works to see the coast and his alternative.
What a lovely day it is. I'm seeing the Central Coast as I've never seen it before. And now we're coming over to, right over the skillion. Wonderful skillion.
But first we see where another pipe may discharge if the advice of Public Works prevails. We see two growing towns crying out to be sewered. We see weed growth from septic tank seepage clogging inland waterways. We see the road and rail, the spine, along which the sudden inland pipe could run north to flat land where lagoons could treat the effluent for reuse on profitable pastures, and to a fold in the hills that he's found, where millions of gallons could be stored during periods of wet. From here, a little brook could take the effluent inland further to more distant farms.
With the breakdown of this system flowing inland into confined areas, it's going to be pretty messy.
Have you looked into any actual figures of returns in dollars that you can get from selling a gallon of sewage to a farmer?
How pure is the water when it goes onto the farms? I mean, what percentage?
Water that is too pure wouldn't be as good for farm use and for pastures as water in which the nutrients are allowed to remain. See, they're fertilisers.
Inland. It sounds so logical, and in fact it's being done in the States and Canada. And we did it too before toilets got sophisticated, before progress and prudishness put pipes into the sea. Each weekend, Francis and Joan are on the move, running down opposition. This trip, we visit the mayor of a farming area, which could use his treated effluent. Effluent which would hitch a ride in the Wallumbai Brook, a brook which just happens to flow inland.
If they came here, we would do everything possible in our power to stop it. We would work through industrially and politically, and if necessary, we would literally carry arms to make sure that this Wallumbyy Brook South Arm was kept pure as it is at the present time.
And I'm very pleased to meet you, Mr. Brown. Very pleased to meet you indeed. And I can say to you that I'm not going to be outdone in love and care for the environment. In fact, my motivation for this whole thing is just love for the environment and care for it. And your brook is just as important as any beach or any other place.
Now, I don't know what precautions you are prepared to take, but as far as we're concerned at this stage, if the water's good and pure, you can put it into Wyong Creek, you can put it where you like, but as far as we're concerned, you're not going to put it into Wallumbyy Brook.
With words, Francis is just too cautious to be forceful. He puts his case best with maps he's drawn and printed up at his own expense.
To treat all this waste and then to put it into the ocean seems to me to be completely absurd.
It would be more expensive if the lines on the Sutton map became real pipes. But how much more? The Public Works Department says approximately $150 million, five times more than their sea disposal scheme.
You've told us you want power stations. Now, I've suggested a power station here. But frankly, I think your suggestion is a better one, because here you have people needing a power station.
He discovers that the mayor of Cessnock wants a power station in his region, but he lacks the millions of gallons of water per day to cool it. Effluent could perhaps do the job.
Hasn't anybody ever thought of incorporating the water from our sewage, Sydney, Melbourne, throughout Australia, and using this to irrigate the vast expanses of land in the interior? And the benefits would be just so great.
We're the driest continent on Earth, and we live on the fringe of our continent, and I think that what you've suggested will eventually come about.
The driest continent on Earth, a sponge ready to soak up wastewater, ready to clean it and be enriched in turn, if people will rethink their wasteful ways.
Why do people want the environment saved? Well, why do they want the environment saved? I mean, I've thought about it. And I thought, well, why do I want the environment saved? And I consider that the answers I give myself are the answers that everybody would be the same for other people, because all people, to my way of thinking, whether they're black people or yellow people or white people, the answers are all the same.
Now, are they the same?
Of course they're the same. The environment is something we need. We gain sustenance from the environment. We have to be able to feel that the environment is perfect. Otherwise, why not just turn all the beautiful areas into concrete jungles and live in those?
He's given up advertising completely and leaves Joan to manage dwindling savings.
They've been 35 or 50 or something cents in the shop, so I'm going to be a bit late with them, but I'm not going to pay all that much money. I'll grow my own.
The more it seems his scheme is shelved, the faster he goes. This Monday morning, he's supposed to be going to the bank. In fact, he's off to get advice on something he'd never have dreamt of doing before, a demonstration. He takes the 8 o'clock ferry from the Longaville jetty.
A lot of people seem to become disconcerted and give in quite quickly. But I don't know quite why this is. The way to retrieve your life, I think, is to start doing something that you love doing, that is really not entirely selfish.
It seems ridiculous, but a mere $5,000 would pay for the first leg of a feasibility study. But though he can't get that $5,000, money is not really the problem. The professionals who build these sewage systems are committed to their own ideas, and they have no time for layman's fancies. But this morning he goes to see a man who does believe in him, Edward St. John, head of the Environment Defence Council, lawyer, politician turned conservationist.
Well, Francis, you're actually planning to hold a demonstration then, are you done?
No, not a demonstration, Ted. It's a symbolic act. We'll have a hoop there about 7 feet round, and this is the size of the pipes they're going to use at the central case.
Well, I don't think there'd be any worries. I think you just go straight ahead and do it. Are you concerned about the police or what?
Well, apart from the problems of police, I think also that I have felt out of my element, and I'm a bit anxious about what will happen with the bus also coming down. It may not be full, and this would be some of the media there. It'd be a terrible fiasco.
You've got to get other people involved with you, perhaps some sort of organisation.
I'm not that kind of a person to organise things. I'm just hoping that organisation.
Yeah, you've got a lot of people now who are really concerned, and I think they'll follow your lead. You know, if you're prepared to.
Well, what's the first step in organising assistance for
well,
yourself?
Well, just start with the people you know up there. You know, start with the people you know and see if they can't help you to get the bus filled.
I suppose you could say over the last 2 years he hasn't shown the slightest interest in money of any sort. Now you haven't, have you?
The mistakes I make, the corrections I make, the people I talk to, the late nights I put into it, are all involved in this determination to achieve some kind of perfection.
You know, at one stage there I suppose, you know, as far as actual money is concerned, we were down to about $500. Well, every now and again, I'd say to you, though, let me finish this, because I'd say to you, you know, the money's getting awfully low. What are we going to do? There's no income of any sort coming in, and you just say to me, oh, I can't think about that now, you know, as though it was just a matter of almost no importance.
St. John said, just go to the people on the coast. So Peter Walsh, who was organiser of a past sewage fight, is a natural choice.
We've got to talk about how we can go about getting your message across. Now, you know, my opinion, for what it's worth, is that you haven't gone about it in the right way. That, you know, your system
what
could
well... What
would
you suggest?
Well, that's the very difficult problem, just how we're going to go about it. Obviously,
shouldn't we have a committee now to raise the $5,000, to do it ourselves, John?
Well, Francis, when you say we, I'd hope
well,
you mean we, the,
I mean,
we,
all
the members
the people
of... Sure, if you meant
inland sewage.
Sure, if you meant we, you and I, I'm, you know, I had that much time and effort placed into this Pelican Island thing that I just simply can't afford the time anymore to fight for what...
Walsh is what Francis isn't. A tactician.
Don't you really just want the Sutton scheme? Isn't that, you know, because that's what people are saying.
No, I'm concerned only with saving the Central Coast from the same pollution that's happened in Sydney. I can see that it can be done. It's quite evident the area hasn't been touched yet. We can have a different system altogether. Now, if my system isn't the one, and a feasibility study proves that another one's a better one, I'll work for that with great diligence. I'd love to be in it.
Francis does impose on people. But he points out that already the Gosford Council and Public Works have chosen another treatment works site, South Kincumber. Just a better Bateau Bay. Activated sludge instead of trickling filter.
This is the South Kincumber Valley. Really, it could be more correctly described as a basin. And when I combed 400 square miles of the Gosford Shire, when I came across this basin, I thought it was fantastic. It was an area which couldn't be created without 100 bulldozers, so beautifully placed for a sewage treatment plant.
Now another beach is threatened, and another crusader is aroused. Barry Horn, president of the new Central Coast Citizens Committee.
The petition has been prepared. It's be circulated this weekend for signatures on the beaches. And over the course of the next 2 or 3 weeks, we hope to canvass every area. And we wonder, you know, what will happen if it surcharges in a dry time. And we'll have this great mountainous sewage just hanging around there for days.
Barry's committee has done what Francis could not do, put together an effective organisation.
No doubt about it. It's a beautiful spot. I think the indication or the suggestion was, in some quarters, what's in it for Sutton? You know, why is he devoting so much of his time to the proposals if there's nothing in it for him?
See, you don't even understand people, I think, like Mr. Horn, who can't understand that you'll do something without any material gain.
His main concern is with the little Lake Cochrane, but I have discovered that what happened to me is going to happen to everyone, and I'm seeing it happening to his little Lake Cochrane.
Right now, having discussed the matter with you today, I'm getting filled with enthusiasm again to the point where, you know, I'm saying to myself, I've got to help this fellow to get across his message, you know? But that's because you've moved me to that point where I now know about your particular problem. Now, if you can move other people to that particular point of view, to that particular state of mind, then they're going to be as enthusiastic to help you as what I am now. And that's the thing that we've got to do. That's where you've got to go to the people in other forms of media other than, say, the newspapers, if you said. You know, we've got to really reach them, out and touch them.
Well, the Sutton scheme is the one that I would honestly like to see go in, because it has had so much research done into it.
You know Mr. Sutton?
I don't know Mr. Sutton. I never met Mr. Sutton. Oh, how do you do? I'm very pleased to meet you. Someone came in and asked me about the sewerage scheme some time ago, and I said that someone should give you an award in the New Year's Honours List. I don't think they've done this, but I do hope that this will go in.
The success of the scheme would be my only reward I would like.
But you have spent a considerable amount of time. I feel myself that I've never got anything in this world unless I've fought for it.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome on our wonderful adventure, and I think that we have to be very proud of the fact that we've been able to organise this trip to Sydney, and
he's done it.
To,
with Joan's help, a busload of Central Coasters heading for Sydney in a demonstration, ready to show Sydney people what is happening on their coast.
About 25 feet length of plywood has been turned into a hoop, and this represents a section of ocean outfall pipe, and we will lean this against the rail near the old tank stream where Sydney's pollution first started, and we will pour buckets of water through this to symbolise what happened in the early history of Australia from about 1788 onwards. We are very, very tranquil, and I don't think that we will be considered to be anything else when we make our appearance at Circular Quay today.
He doesn't have confidence in other people. I suppose this is... It's funny, that, isn't it? In some ways. And yet it's his baby, you see. It's one of his... he's had all his little babies, but this is his big baby that he's... Yeah, you know, just come along recently.
Here we go.
The hoop symbolises the pipe to go into the sea near Lake Cochrane.
Come on, in you go with
the water, the effluent, from the Kincumber Works to be...
Because it's been a one-man show, really, isn't it? Well, it's his creation.
For goodness sake, come on. Now, hold this down, would you?
This is marvellous, that all these people took the trouble to come for 2 hours here to do a thing and go 2 hours back again.
Can you imagine? Look, let's get these into the car. Where are the other buckets?
Oh, I think we have to go, Mike, because Francis has to go to Parliament House.
We've got to go up to Parliament House now.
Well, I'm very glad to see so many people turned up, because it's very bad weather, isn't it?
Yeah.
Bad day for it.
OK, rolling.
And what's your next step?
Our next step after this meeting, I think, is to wait to see what the federal government, how their reaction to the two letters that we are going to deliver.
A letter to the state government. Please investigate inland scheme before proceeding further.
What media people? You had Channel 7?
We had Channel 7. And yes. I think we had one good one, that's good enough.
Yeah, good. Fine.
I was very surprised the others didn't come.
Yes. Ah, well.
I'll give the press reports to the...
You start with one and it catches on with the others.
Well, it's an important venture to be carried out with such short notice, Mike. Was so pleasing as far as I'm concerned. We've put a lot of effort into this at Avoca Beach.
We had high hopes.
Where did you give the letter to inside for the
to
Premier?
To the desk at the left.
Yeah. Wouldn't it have been better to take it down to the Premier as well?
Oh, he'll get it tomorrow, won't he?
Well, that's right, he'll get it tomorrow, yeah. Well,
would you advise he take us further today?
Well, you could have went to the State Office block and
that's where the Premier is.
That's where he is. That's where he is.
Yes, but
he's not here.
He probably wouldn't be there anyway because he's out on electioneering.
Well, yes, that's right, yeah.
But I think that we've more or less completed our purpose. These people have come down from the Central Coast.
Mm. All right.
And,
yeah.
Do you see that he gets it?
Oh, yes, we'll see that he gets it. Yes, he'll be right. He'll get it. Oh, yes.
Well, they're a very peaceful bunch of people.
Perhaps. The trouble with Francis is that he's just too unassuming to be really effective.
I think that the only way to persuade them against that feeling is if we could have a feasibility report, but unfortunately...
Francis is stumped. People think his scheme will cost too much. Joan suggests asking an old friend, a sewage treatment expert.
Well, you suggested, Mr. Parker, I think if you could just get him to give you enough information to make it, sound reasonable and possible financially, could you do that?
Well,
but Francis hates to ask Parker because he's already helped a lot. I pursue another course on the cost question. I make an appointment with Mr. McIntosh, Chief Engineer of the Department of Public Works. It's said that the 150 million figure comes from his office. Francis is not invited.
Well, why not? I don't know. I think they're scared of you.
Yeah. I think they must have been too. Well, I think that's a disappointment, isn't it? See, that's a drawing that I've made which show the two systems. Yeah.
But I can't take that, because if I take that, then I'm really promoting your particular scheme too much, I think.
Oh, well, leave it out then. I'm not. If they don't want to do it, have anything to do with me, well, that's okay. Let them go ahead the way they want to go. I find it very difficult to find out the cost of my scheme, but certainly I would like the Public Works Department to put a price on it.
It's ideal to have nothing affecting your environment at all. That is, you continue on as nature made it. Nevertheless, man can improve his environment. And the people at Gosford are generating wastes and they have to be got rid of. So the department offers advice. I stress this point because of its vast and knowledge in the subject. So you get to the situation of the local people saying, well, that is not good enough for us. We want this other. We say, well, that is your decision. If you want that, you pay for it. The community has to pay for it. And it's just a question of this department not trying to take the view that Mr. Sutton's scheme isn't ideally desirable. We're saying, can the community pay?
It's generally believed, and the people I've talked to up there, that that Public Works, and even yourself in particular, have given a figure on of what an inland scheme would cost. And that's between 100 and 150 million. Now, is that correct?
Well, it would be of this order when you speak as of being correct. Is it correct that we've made such a submission? That is true, but remembering it's done on very preliminary investigation basis. He places quite a lot of reliance upon industrial water and also on irrigation. Now, can it be taken for granted that the irrigators will want this water? Will they take it? And
surely that's the same problems you face with putting it into the sea. I mean, in both cases, you have to convince somebody. Therefore, since the convincing cancels out...
Is it necessary to use it for irrigation? And will the people that are going to use it accept it, knowing the origin of the of the waste.
What about power plant, using it for cooling power plants?
Well, again, is this necessary? In the situation along our coast, I can only see it becoming more and more necessary to use the ocean for our waste disposal, because I believe technology is of and will continue to develop to be of such a high order that the concerns of the public can be allayed.
It was fantastic, I think. They probably persuaded you that they were right and their theories were correct.
I come away with lots of news. News that McIntosh would be glad to see him any time.
And that it's a question of cost for your scheme, cost alone, that you're not a crackpot, that you're not crazy, that your scheme is perfectly feasible.
They said I wasn't a crackpot, did they?
No,
well, that's
no.
Nice.
They said it's perfectly feasible.
Yeah.
How about that?
Very nice. I'm pleased to hear that.
If they'd had that feasibility study done, I wouldn't be in the dilemma that I'm at the moment.
Well,
I shouldn't have to do anything more, should I?
Mere amateurs, like yourself, can come in and teach the experts because they come in with open minds and a determination to solve the problem.
Yes, that might be partly the case, Ted, but I think that the Public Works Department knows very well what they are doing will degrade the environment, but they have a certain amount of money to spend for the whole of New South Wales, and they work on their budget, and they have to use their public relations to convince the people that it's going to be quite all right.
But
quite satisfactory.
Right, are they right in assuming that it's necessarily going to be far more costly to do it your way?
Well, I think they could be wrong there, but they may not want the precedent of inland sewage in Australia. I don't know.
Of course, another thing, if they give inland sewage to Gosford, I suppose people might say, why the heck didn't you have inland sewage for Sydney?
For someone like Francis, excuses for giving up come each day. Reasons for going on are rarer.
Awakening of pleasant feelings upon arriving in the country. Really lovely. I just better clean that record, I think. Beethoven. He just casual in his diary, he said, I never feel entirely well except when I'm amongst scenes of unspoiled nature. Lifts one's spirits and helps one recover from all the exhaustions and pressures of life. Is the music of a man who loved nature and probably more than any of the composers, as far as I know.
Jonathan comes up from Melbourne for the weekend with his girlfriend Peter. As you can imagine, Francis is itching to tell him the latest sewage developments.
That's right, you've got something. The Roman haircut now, that's all.
Well, I did it about. It's right here. It's getting put on. I always do it. I find that if you lean over like this and look in the mirror and you can sort of cut like this and it.
Oh, you did it yourself.
This is the creative process. The art of conveying those values onto younger minds and people with the full strength of their life in front of them is to enrich your own life, really, because your children are a continuity of yourself.
I've got Brisbane Waters.
This is an out. Yeah.
I'll just give you an idea of the whole of it, because that would say that it's Brisbane Waters there. They come up the Tugra Lakes.
We have a development along here, see? This is where the development is all taking place. And it's going to be
exciting developments for Francis too. Barry Horn's committee is holding a public meeting tonight to protest South Kincumber. They may take the study off his shoulders.
I'd like to get into quieter waters now and
perhaps write a small piece about why I feel the way I do.
Don't you get a bit frustrated though that with all these things are so obvious, you know, when you think about them, but you know, people just don't seem to respond to the ideas that you're putting forward.
Well, the trouble
is, why is this? Does it get you?
No, the people do respond. The people do respond. They put a council in at Gosford on a mandate.
I think the Sutton scheme should certainly be investigated, and I endorse it privately. But with all these sorts of things, the question is always asked, what's in it for the individual?
It's going to be a very vigorous meeting, because we're people that are as one, because we are for the one thing. We're fighting for what we believe. This is almost an affair of the heart.
We're not just a bunch of hicks, are we?
All I know is that I've had a little experience of fighting this kind of battle, and I know the kind of forces that are pitted against them. They're pitted against us. This is the extraordinary, terrible thing that we come to realise, that our councils and our governments very often don't seem to be on our side anymore, and we've got to teach them how we feel, where we stand, what we do.
The next speaker, Councillor Brooks, is unscheduled. He says he supports an inland scheme, but...
A different side of the subject that is before you. I believe we're only left with two alternatives. An ocean outfall or an estuary outfall. Now you've got... I'm sorry, ladies and gentlemen, you've got no other alternative. The other alternative is that we do not have sewage at all for the Gosford Shire. And you've heard a lot of talk about sewage tonight, and I would just like to show you the sewage that will be going into the ocean. And I would like to just...
Why don't you drink it now?
Drink it! Drink it!
Wouldn't put it in your bloody whiskey.
I'm just trying to...
Drink it!
I would not drink it.
Mr. Chairman,
I have an agenda here.
It has to go somewhere. It will cause far more pollution if we don't do something about sewage. If we take a completely negative attitude, it will be running down your curbs and gutters in 10 or 15 years. You may not be here.
Mr. Chairman, I vote that this cease. We responsible for the calling of this meeting, and I'm one of the five, did not come here to listen to this diatribe on the virtues of a councillor who made this scheme possible. And I would like... I move that this speech be ceased now.
My name's Jonathan Sutton. Although I'm only visiting from Melbourne, I know that my father has been working on a fight very similar to here at the present time. I'm just wondering why he was not invited to talk.
With all due respect, this is a public meeting. It's a call for the purpose of alerting people in this area to what is happening. Now, there may be a time in the future at which Mr. Sutton may be invited to speak, but at this stage, we have only a limited amount of time. Mr. St. John and Dr. Mullins are the two speakers, and I'm sorry, but we've had to leave it at that. No, it's for no other reason. We are interested in the scheme and we would like to see it investigated, but we are not prepared to discuss the technicalities at this stage.
He doesn't shine at this sort of thing. It's an effort, and I think it's painful for him, really.
You tell me what you want me to do and I'll try and give you a straight answer.
What
do you want me to do? No, you don't feel... What do you want me to do? Tell me, please, how I can help you.
I want your committee, which is a coastal waters pollution...
Yes, I realise that. What do you want me to do?
...prevention committee.
Yeah.
I want you to support a feasibility study of the scheme that has been put forward, and for which two councils have requested from one of Australia's leading scientists a report on the cost of a feasibility study.
I cannot give you that assurance now. I will put it to the committee, certainly.
That's all I wanted to know.
We have got no argument with you.
Come on, Suey, home you come.
I find it very difficult to get my thoughts over.
Yes, thanks very much.
I can have the thoughts, and the thoughts are clear when I'm on my own, and I often become speechless when I have so much I'd like to say.
Peter, if you think I seem a bit fed up sometimes about France's scheme, well, I am, you know. It's been going on, I think, for...
Well, if you have been feeling a bit fed up, why don't you think about leaving things just for a while and coming down and staying in Melbourne with Jonathan and with me?
Every time I'm working hard to point out why he's different from everybody else, and every time I do that, he fights back like mad and says, oh, no, I'm the same as everybody else. And they're all the same. They'd all do this if they had the opportunity or if they had something. But it's not true. What? It isn't true, Francis.
Oh, yes, it is.
No, it isn't, dear.
People are the same no matter where you go.
Francis doesn't have any cynicism in his nature.
Okay,
it
some.
Is. No,
everybody
you,
has some.
But at your age, if you still have that enormous faith in people, which you've quite convinced is unshakable,
everybody
that it shows faith. You don't have... we're much the same age, and yet I'm much more cynical than you are.
I wasn't prepared to put in the effort myself when I was looking after my family.
Oh, you just... That's just
because I became freed from my family.
And what about
because
all?
I became freed from my family, and when I became freed from my family, I became involved in the issue, and when I became involved in the issue took over me.
Ah, but how many times have I said to you over the last few months, look, why don't you give it away? Haven't you done enough?
Yes,
why
we've didn't had you some give it? Pretty bad rows, haven't
why,
we?
Not really rows, we've had disagreements.
No.
And why didn't you give it up?
Well, it's on the subject of rows, let me just tell you.
I didn't ask that question.
Oh, you didn't. Why didn't I give it up?
Yes.
All right. Because I couldn't.
Can't give it up.
I just can't.
You've got a quality there that makes it impossible for you to give it up. You've dedicated yourself to it.
I go to you.
I'm not able to dedicate myself to the situation. I know all about it. You've told me all about
That's
it.
Right.
I know the
yeah.
environment suffering, but I am not
yes.
able to dedicate myself
all
the
right.
way you are. And I even get fed up.
Oh, yes,
I even
are.
Say, even it's getting worse.
All right,
I feel now I'm in a net. I feel I've got to escape.
Well,
I feel
from
I
my
can't stand.
From my point of view, I it's just simply that you always hurt the one you love, I suppose. I think it's just too hard, really. It's too much to ask of other people, particularly when it goes on and on and on.
A week has passed since Francis sent pipe links and pumping station statistics to C.D. Parker in Melbourne. Now Francis meets Parker between flights at Sydney Airport to get the results.
I've put forward, these particular lines. I don't know whether... I think he stuck to those more.
Now, the additional cost is the cost of, first of all, collecting it to pumping stations at the various
yes.
points, and then the sewers, which will convey it.
For Parker, this stuff is easy. He is, after all, a world expert in the field of wastewater.
Size that we're talking about.
Yes.
So the total cost is $28 million against the Works Department scheme of $23 million, making a net increase of the for the Sutton scheme over the Works Department scheme of something of the order of $5 million. This, is, again, is extremely rough. It could be anywhere between 5 and 20, but it's certainly nowhere near the figure of 150 to 200 million that has been spoken of.
I had to come back. I've got some letters
Hello.
For you, and most
I
important
I saw the car
one.
There.
Oh, that's nothing. We'll talk about that later.
Yeah.
From the Prime Minister.
Thank you very
How's
much.
That?
Good.
You're excited?
I certainly am.
I'd like to open this one too. This says Minister for Urban and Regional Development. We'll keep that a moment. How fascinating, both coming at once.
Yeah, it is rather. Exciting.
Great, right?
Dear Mr. Sutton, the Prime Minister has received your further letter of the 7th of February 1973 and the attachment regarding your Three Shire Inland Sewage and Water Reuse Plan and has noted their contents. Your correspondence has been referred to the appropriate Commonwealth authorities for consideration.
Oh.
That's it.
Exactly, private and personal. Open this one. Mm.
From Mr. Uren, Minister for Urban and Regional Development. Dear Mr. Sutton, the studies being conducted by the government are being pursued vigorously. However, it can be expected that some time will elapse before our considered comprehensive proposals become available. Yes, you see, that means that we've got to get some kind of interim plans as soon as possible.
But that's the same letter.
It's the same letter, but it means the same thing. I don't know why they repeat, yeah, send me the same one twice.
It doesn't mean anything.
No.
That'd be frightening, wouldn't it?
What?
I said, could it mean, that doesn't mean anything. I often
well,
suspect.
Anyhow, it's very nice that you came back.
Oh, thank you. And it's very nice of those gentlemen to write to you, isn't it?
Oh, I'm used
to... glad to be back.
So you're a bit disappointed?
No, no, I've had so many letters that have just been full of promise, particularly from the Public Works Department. They were going to carry out a study on the claims I made about Baddow Bay. But they just stopped and the outfall went out and the thing malfunctioned and only at that stage did anybody take any notice.
So you don't care anymore?
Oh, no, it's not that I don't care, it's just that I'll wait and see what happens. Keep pushing, carry on regardless.
I was dying for a cup of tea. I've done the cleaning.
Francis will release the Parker figures to the press, but first a little relaxation. Making a new map to show attractive new features.
I'm very happy that Mr. Sutton is using the motel for the press conference, and he's been doing such marvellous work for years, and I will help him whatever I can.
Anyhow, it was finally finished, I think, about 1 o'clock he went to bed. Then the alarm went off this morning. There's a wild scramble. I said, look, run into the shower first and get dressed, you know, organise nicely so that you'll be ready to... Then you can pick up all your stuff. Oh, no, I said, I can't do that. So running around in his pyjamas as usual, you know, and got all his papers together. And we had a sort of mad breakfast with everyone falling all over everyone else and watching the time. But we made it, didn't we? Not before 9, but at 9.
Do we start doing this now, or you
oh,
think?
Oh, whenever
or?
You're ready, Mr. Sutton.
Very good. Well, there were some others coming. Who's here now? There's some said that they'd
well,
be a little
Wendy's
bit late.
Well, Wendy's from the Star, I'm from the Express.
I see, and you cover other papers, do you?
Yes, all the papers around here.
You cover all the papers?
Yeah.
Oh, then, I don't suppose there's any reason why we shouldn't go ahead, then.
No.
Well, perhaps we'd better sit down. I think I've stated it pretty well in the statement there, but there are one or two other points here that I'd like to make. I've got something else here which I would like to read out to you. Do you think you can take it down as I give it to you?
Mm-hmm.
I'll read it slowly. If I go too fast, stop me. The people of Gosfordshire decided what they wanted and selected leaders to carry out their wishes. But we find our representatives' hands are tied, their lips are sealed,
by dependency on Public Works Department subsidy.
The press conference is surprisingly successful, and about the same time I go to see Tom Uren in Canberra, Federal Minister of Urban and Regional Development, the author of the second letter.
Well, let's talk about Mr. Sutton. Mr. Sutton came to me when I was in opposition, and I promised him that I would have his scheme thoroughly examined, and in fact, that's what's being done at present. They're really examining his proposal. In fact, I think, and I'm not committing my government to his proposal, but I think his proposal is a far saner one than what the New South Wales Public Works proposal are prepared to do.
Some of the people who've been supporting an inland scheme have developed the idea that the best way they could help the federal government would be to pay for the first leg of a feasibility study themselves, as a sort of a gesture of commitment.
No, look, there's already a feasibility study underway. And we've spent an enormous amount of money on this feasibility study on the Central Coast.
Well, are you going to abandon your thing now?
Abandon my scheme?
No. You're collecting the 5,000.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I think that the public spirit should be encouraged to continue.
Besides, Francis doesn't abandon things. You know that by now, Mike.
The sewerage is only a part of the overall feasibility study. Mm-hmm. And this is what I can't really always seem to make people understand, that theirs is only one part of the overall study.
You're a stubborn man. He just told you not to do it.
He didn't say not to do it.
Yes, he did.
You know, he virtually did, yes.
Is that so?
Mm-hmm. He said you shouldn't bother because they're busy.
Oh, well, perhaps we won't do it then. If he said that, I didn't hear that. Give us the piece back again, will you?
No.
There are always experts to tell you that you can do this and you can't do that, usually that you can't do something. There are always such experts. But there are also, fortunately, men and women of goodwill who come in with the courage of their convictions and the determination to find an answer, and time and again they are proved right and the experts are wrong. I think that's what may happen with Francis Sutton. We want a report on the Sutton scheme.
I don't think I'm very demonstrative naturally. I'm not at all like that, and I felt that perhaps I wasn't a good person to be involved in such a film.
There's no clear success in sight. Such stories don't end in a day. Francis works on and drops me notes from time to time when there's progress to report.